Hey everyone, this is Marbozir, and this is part 11 of Let's Play Civilization 5 Gods and Kings as Austria. In the previous part, I was preparing for war with Hiawatha, and in this part, I'm going to actually declare it. And I'm actually going to start from that. I think I can take this city quite easily, in fact. He doesn't have a huge army. I actually lost my number one military power spot, but I'm not too far behind, and he's not number one, the Mongols are. And I think the Mongols are actually quite busy at the moment. Actually, no, they aren't. They aren't at war with anyone, or are they? No. But I did leave enough defenses back at home to be safe. Even if they were to declare war on me right now, I think I will be fine. Also, in other news, I didn't actually finish the Oxford University in Vienna. Because I annexed Sparta while it was under construction, and Sparta doesn't have university. So now I'll have to build university in Sparta before I can finish my Oxford University, but that's actually good. I can use my Oxford University for something more useful. For a more useful technology, at least, that would otherwise take longer to get. Anyway, let's focus on this. I need to get rid of all of his units first, and then I can start bombarding Osininka with my two artillery units from this hex, and from this hex probably. I'm going to start from getting rid of his cannon. Should be able to do that with two frigates. But it will be close actually. No, probably not. But it will go down on the next turn. So now I can use my privateer to get rid of this musket man, and then I can bombard his ship. I have two more frigates to use. So let's do it like this. I don't want to move into his city's bombardment range for as long as I can, because he does have a cannon inside. So if I move within two hexes of this city, he will bombard me with the city itself and with the cannon inside. That's quite a lot of firepower. He could probably kill any of my units in one turn if he fires both with the city and with the cannon at the same unit. And the AI is smart enough to do that. Not that it takes a grand strategist to focus firepower from two different sources on one unit. Oh hey, Darius declared war. Nice, so now the Mongols will be busy with the Persians. Oh, he's actually attacking Florence. That's not good, that's my city. Peace off, dude. And Florence can't really defend itself. Damn it, I might actually lose it. Holy crap, he has a lot of artillery units. I mean, cannons. Yeah, Florence is probably going to fall. But I'm not really worried about that. I need to focus on this. No, I'm not going to declare war on Alexander. I already took his capital and his second biggest city. If I can take this city, or when I take this city, I should be pretty close in score to Hiawatha, and I will definitely weaken him significantly. This is his biggest city right now, it's even bigger than his capital. And I think this is one of the biggest cities on the map. I didn't see any other city with over 20 population. I do think that's the biggest city on the map right now, and if not, it's close to being one. So this will give me a nice boost as well. Right, let's continue this. I need to move my artillery over here. And I might as well land one of my units here already. No point waiting with that. So let's start moving them over. Also, I'll need to move this artillery here, but not just yet. I need to get rid of these ships first, anyway. He's going down. I don't need to watch where I move though, because if I move into this hex, for example, he will be able to bombard me from Osininka. And that's not what I want to happen. And that's all I can do for now. I can get rid of this cannon. And that's about it. Oh, did I get a great admiral? Yeah, I did. Nice. But I don't think it's very safe transferring him to Hanoi. If he meets any ships on the way, I would lose my second great admiral. I'm not too sure about this. It's probably safer to move through here. Is Hiawatha at war with anyone other than me? Let's have a look. No, he's not. Okay, so I'm going to send my great admiral east. But I need to watch out. If I see any of Hiawatha's ships on the way, I'm just going to turn back and go back home. Okay, do I have any other frigates to use? Yeah, I do. But I can't really do much with this one. I can bombard the worker, yay? But hey, that's always 2 experience from that. Right, so now I need to get university in Sparta, because I needed to actually finish my Oxford University. Okay, that was a good turn overall. Hopefully it will continue like that. The Mongols are plotting against me, yeah, that's a... I'm curious how the demographic screen is going to look like once I take this city. It should give me a big boost. And I'm pretty sure I would be able to take his capital. It looks more than doable, honestly. He doesn't have that many units. I'm actually surprised he doesn't have a bigger land army. I'm surprised he didn't bring more units over to defend himself. Where are all his units? His army wasn't that strong, but he was pretty strong from what I remember. I'm actually third right now. I'm not sure if he's second or someone else. Well, anyway, it doesn't matter. This is just a formality if he doesn't bring a significantly bigger army. I don't think I'm even going to lose anything. So much for that frigate. And he's about to lose this pikeman as well. And I will be able to start bombarding his city, maybe even on the next turn. I can land my artillery over here and start bombarding him on the next turn with the great general. Looks good. And I can land one more. He will be able to start bombarding my riflemen here, but I'll just move him out of range on the next turn. Speaking of which, do I need to bribe any city? Not right now. Right, it's time to move this artillery into Osininka's range. Looks like he only has 1 ship left, 2 ships left. city states. There we go. Let's get out of here. And let's start the bombardment. I do have volley on one of my artillery units, on this one. So that will make it faster. I still need to get rid of this ship. But that shouldn't be a problem. I can hit him with 3 frigates without getting in range of this city, or with 2 frigates. Yeah, only with 2. But that's good enough. I'm not moving into bombardment range just yet. I would if it wasn't for this cannon. But with this cannon, he has a bit too much firepower in Osininka. I don't give him more than maybe 5 more turns. He's going down after that. Right, do I have open borders with Russians? No, I don't. So I would have to go through here. I could just sign open borders with them, maybe. That would be faster, honestly. Let's do it.
Здравствуй.
Open borders.
Продолжай.
Nice. Do they want anything from me?
Продолжай.
Nope. Grants, yeah, public school. I'm just going to build public schools everywhere. Especially in any city with decent science rating. Which is most of them. This is looking really good for me. I honestly expected bigger resistance from Hiawatha. He's not even bringing any land units over here. Is this his entire land army? If he had more units on this island, land units that is, they would probably already be here, especially with these roads. So that's a bit surprising. Turns out I won't really need all these land units. Maybe they will be useful against the capital. So that's actually a big question. Should I go after his capital once I take Osininka? Oh nice, I got a promotion. I'm actually going to grab strength against naval units. Because I'm mostly going to use my frigates against naval units, not against cities. Oh, hey, he does have great war infantry, or at least he's building some. I should get rid of that. Seems like a good idea. I don't think I can reach him with my privateer, no. Oh well. I don't think he can get away though. I'd rather finish this ship. Actually, that's a great merchant. Public school again. Yeah, I'll be doing around 80 damage just with my artillery units. So, 2 or 3 turns max, and Osininka will be mine. What should I get in Hanoi? I think I'm going to grab a factory. I want this city to have higher production than this. Just moving my privateer up here to catch this great war infantry. Although he could land over here. If he does, I'll just finish it off with my frigate. He's blocking the way. And you know, it's actually quite convenient that Persians are at war with the Mongols, because they will keep them busy with each other, which will keep Mongols off my back. And even if one of them gains any kind of significant advantage, which I don't think will happen because they both got pretty big armies, none of them can get strong enough to be a threat to me. So this is more than convenient. And they are on the same island, so I think this war is going to take a while. The Mongols have a pretty strong army. The Mongols have the strongest army right now, I think. Unless I pass them. Steam power is done, nice. Yeah, I didn't pass them. No, the Persians have the strongest army. Oh, okay, so the Mongols had to be second. Because Mongols were first just few turns ago, and now the Persians are first. So this means Mongols and Persians have the first and second strongest army, which is just barely stronger than mine. And Hiawatha has to be fourth or lower. But yeah, looking at his army, he's definitely not strong at all. Okay, where's that Great War Infantry? I don't see it anymore. Oh, there he is. And his ship. So I might not be able to sink this. Probably not. I don't want to move here because then the city-state will be able to bombard me. Another ship down. But this Great War Infantry is still up. And I can't catch him with my privateer. Actually, yeah, I can. But then I would have to move into this city's range. Whatever, let's do it. He doesn't have any kind of artillery in there, so he can't sink me. At least, I don't think so. More experience for me. And let's continue the bombardment. Three more turns max and the city is going down. I could start landing some of my units near the city. I could land my Gatling gun to do some damage on the next turn. I'm actually going to do that. Then I can start moving these in. I need some land unit over here anyway to take the city. And oh yeah, that was artillery for defense. So now I'm going to build another public school in Salzburg. And with this artillery over here, I should be really safe. Especially with Mongols busy with the Persians. I have to be careful in this area because the Iroquois actually have some cities over here. So maybe I should go north instead. And go around this island to make it slightly safer. I'm not sure yet, we'll see. Let's see, what can I research next? I'm going to go for railroad, because then I can connect my cities and get a production bonus. Not to mention I can go for combustion after that and get destroyer and landship. So that sounds like a good plan. Vienna, what can I grab in Vienna? I have three more turns before the university is done. Does Hanoi have a university? I think it does. Yeah, it does. So I need something that takes three turns, so I can switch to Oxford University after that one is done. I could just grab a castle or armory. Or I could just get workshop and then switch to wealth production for one turn. So it turns out Hiawatha wasn't really as strong as I thought he is. I think he focused a lot on civilian research and production. His army is pretty weak. Oh, did my unit go down? No, it didn't. But that was pretty close. The city-state isn't even bombarding me. Oh, never mind, it's not the city-state's turn yet. So honestly, I think my victory is fairly secure now. Hiawatha was the only one who was perhaps able to threaten it. But I'm about to conquer his cities. And once I take this city over here, Osininka, and his capital, he won't be a threat to me. And the Mongols will be busy with Persians. So I don't really see any civilization on the map right now that could threaten my victory. Right, I should be able to take this on this turn, but I need to use my frigates for bombardment. Let's do that. I can definitely take it on this turn. Yeah, he's going down. And this will actually be a pretty decent city once I annex it. It should be size 11. I should have targeted this cannon with my other frigate. But whatever, it doesn't matter. Osininka is mine. Awesome. So now the question is, should I go after his capital or not? I'm pretty sure I can actually take his capital, but it might give me some happiness problems. I need to maintain positive happiness. Because if I lose positive happiness, I'm going to lose plus 15% bonus, which is currently worth 51 science. That's a lot. Losing 51 science would hurt. And I need to assign my spy again. I'll just send him to one of Hiawatha's cities. Doesn't really matter which. Any city other than his capital, actually. So this one looks good. Grand River. Where is it? Oh, it's this one. Okay. Oh, his capital actually has ivory, which I don't have. No, I don't. So I think I'm going to go after his capital. I need to be careful about this, but I think it's doable just fine. Wait, why can't I move here? That's a bit strange. Oh, I'm out of moves, never mind. But this war is easier than I expected. I expected way bigger resistance. So this just shows how misleading the score can be. And speaking of score, look at this. He's only 42 points ahead of me now. So if I take his capital, I'm going to pass him by a large margin. Another public school. And another public school. Once I get all these public schools, I'm going to easily pass him in literacy. I'm only 3% behind. And I need to get this Oxford University. It's going to be done in 4 turns or 5 turns. So I can get some nice technology out of that. I'm totally going to pass him very, very soon. He doesn't have that many technologies that I don't. Come on. Let me open the technology screen. Oh, now he wants peace. Sorry, bro. I want your capital. Yeah, let's have a look. I know he has replaceable parts since he had Great War Infantry. The Japanese? No, I'm not going to go to war with Japanese. Sorry, bro. So I know he has electricity, and I know he has replaceable parts. That's what I do know. I don't think he has railroad, because I didn't see any railroads on his island. No, he definitely doesn't have railroad. Although it's quite possible he got it just recently and didn't start any railroads yet. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm going to pass him quite easily. Oh hey, my city wants ivory. That's convenient, since I am going to get it. Right, I'm going to grab strength against naval units again. Let's get rid of this cannon. And the ship will go down as well. This guy has targeting too. Awesome. And I should be able to bombard his capital, at least from this hill. Quite happy with how this war is going. Obviously. Who wouldn't be, right? I don't think he has many ships left by now. I'm second now. And I'm only 2k, 1.k behind Persians. I'm probably going to be first because Persians are at war with the Mongols and they are both losing units. So this should easily give me the number one military power. Which means my victory feels fairly secure. I could go for several different victory types right now, honestly. Domination would be the hardest and I'm not really going for domination, but it would totally be possible if I wanted to switch to that for fun. Okay, now I need to be careful, there could be some of Hiawatha's ships around here. I see his worker. Lose that admiral. Vienna. Oh yeah, the university in Sparta is almost done, so I'm going to switch Vienna to wealth production for one turn, or actually to research production. No, I'm not going to war with Alexander. You go. Are these the cities that were allied with Darius? Oh nice, I got Great Engineer. That's actually going to be very useful. There are some wonders I could possibly use. Not right now, but there will be. I'm not sure if anyone got Statue of Liberty yet. That could be useful for me. I would obviously need to get the technology for it first. But plus one production from specialists in every city would be pretty nice for me. So I'm going to keep him for now. And now I can actually switch to Oxford University in my capital. What? I can't? Never mind, I can. I was looking at something else. And back to Graz. I can get more culture, I suppose. I'm not going for Brandenburg Gate because it's a bit too late for that. If I had one city that was dedicated to military production, had military academy and all that stuff, then it would make sense getting Brandenburg Gate. But right now, I don't think it makes sense. And I'm about to start bombarding his capital. I could just play it. And I think I'm going to do that. Then I can just go in and take it with the privateer. It's going to take quite a few turns, but that's the safest way to do it. And he doesn't really have anything to prevent me from doing that. Oh, I see his frigate, I need to back up now. I think I'll just go around or something like that. I don't want to lose this admiral. Before I actually take his capital, I need to raise my happiness a little bit. I am going to get extra luxury resource from his capital, but I need to watch out. If I lose my 15% bonus from happiness, I'm going to lose a lot of science. Hanoi is starving, what? Are you serious? Oh, I lost Venice. Not good. What? I lost quite a lot of influence in there. I actually need to spend 500 now. That's annoying. Well, let's do it anyway. Oh, are the Persians attacking Venice? And I lost Florence as well, but I'm not sure if it's worth taking Florence back. He was actually attacking Florence not long ago. Although he might be busy with Darius now. Let's take it. But let's have a look at Hanoi. Why is it starving? I have no idea. No, it's not starving. The notifications lie. I guess the automatic management might have changed it. Whatever, doesn't matter. Let's keep moving here. Oh, that was a bad move actually, and I can't take it back now. I could have moved here. Oh well, not a big deal. I'm not in a rush. His capital will go down anyway. But looks like I need some meat shields over here. And I need to move my frigates over. Oh yeah, I need to get rid of this ironclad. Right, hold on. He does have a lancer over here, so I need to block the way. I don't have that many meat shield units here. I need to watch out what I'm doing. Alright, let's see. I need to get rid of the ironclad. Let's start from that. And then I'm going to move some of my frigates over here, so I can bombard his land units. But this ironclad will be quite tough to take out with frigates. Oh, I shouldn't have used privateer there. That should have been last. Oh well, doesn't matter. He will go down anyway. But that was a minor screw up. I should have used privateer on the last attack. Okay, looking good. Oh yeah, I need to reassign my spies. I almost forgot about that. Or do I? No, I don't. One is in the capital, another is in Grand River. Oh, I'm going to steal a technology in 12 turns. Should I relocate him now? I think I'm going to take his capital in less than 12 turns. So, if I don't want to waste my spies' time, I should relocate him now. I do think this is going to fall in less than 12 turns, so I'm going to relocate this spy. To one of his other cities, preferably one of the bigger ones, like Buffalo Creek. That seems like an obvious choice. Yeah, let's do that. And public school, I think. Or Colosseum, actually. Yeah, I need more happiness. I need any kind of happiness buildings I can get, so none in Quebec City, unfortunately. What about here? Yeah, I can get a theater in Klagenfurt. That should give me enough happiness to deal with the capital. And Osinica will be out of resistance in... Wow, 8 turns, really? I guess that's because of how big it was. Wow, I might actually lose my unit over here. That's not good. I think I'll have to target his lancer with my artillery now. You want my spices again? I'm actually going to refuse. I need to watch my income. I'm only at +8 right now. But I can get a few more banks from what I remember. Sydney seeks a great scientist. That's good. I should get one pretty soon from my capital. Hiawatha is plotting against the Japanese. Trade route established. Oh yeah, that's why I only had plus 8, right. That explains a lot. Where did his lancer go? Not strange. He was here just a moment ago. Derp. Should I continue bombarding his capital or his trebuchet? I'll just bombard his capital. My frigates are coming anyway. They can take care of it. It's just a matter of time before his capital falls. And I have more than enough mid-shield units over here. I can get more if I want to. Hopefully my great admiral will be able to get over here without getting destroyed. Should I move over there? I don't want to go into Onondaga's bombardment range if I don't have to. So I'm going to hold out on that. Probably safer to move my great general back. Oh yeah, the Oxford University is done, so I can pick a free technology. So, I'm already researching railroad, so obviously I'm not going to pick that. I'm not sure about this yet. Interesting choice. I could get flight and save more research points. Or I could get electricity and then get replaceable parts on the next turn. I kind of want to try getting Statue of Liberty. I don't remember if anyone built it. But if not, I definitely want Statue of Liberty. So I'm actually going to grab electricity. This also unlocks stock exchange. Right, I'm going to grab this. This saves me less points than if I were to grab flight. But I think it makes more sense from progress point of view. So let's do it.
Is it?
Nice. What? I don't have any aluminium. I do have one over here. But I don't have worker anywhere close. Wow, that's annoying. What about the other one? Near Salzburg? Yep. Is that a worker inside or what? I can't actually click it, that's annoying. Very annoying. What? Seriously? Oh, that's a great general, damn it. I thought it's a worker. Oh, there's a worker over here. This should be enough aluminium. 8 here. And 8 here, yeah, that's 16, that's more than enough. Alright, what should I get in Vienna? I think I'm going to get National Epic, actually. It's a bit late for that now, but hey, better late than never, right? But should I switch to production focus instead? No, I shouldn't. Yeah, I'm going to go for National Epic. Although, maybe I should get factory first. I don't know. Nah, I'm going for National Epic. That will give me a few more great scientist points. I think I'm done here. Yep. I'm still not sure where his lancer is. Did he withdraw it? I don't want him to just appear out of the blue and attack my artillery. But on the other hand, I don't want to stand in Onondaga's bombardment range if I don't have to. Yeah, there he is. My frigates are almost there, so they should be able to take care of some of them. I can bombard them 3 times without going into Buffalo's Creek bombardment range. So I can bombard the Lancer twice with my frigates and trebuchet once. Let's do that. Oh wow, that's a lot of damage. Yeah, they do more damage than I thought they do. So much for that Lancer. Do I have bombardment on anyone else? Yeah, this frigate has bombardment too. Now imagine how much harder this would be if he had actual artillery units with 3 hex range. That would be significantly harder, actually. Okay, my Great Admiral is here. I need to be careful. Maybe I should send some... Actually, I don't see his capital anymore. I need to move. Oh, wow, that's annoying. I guess I have to move over here. I don't really have a choice if I want to keep bombarding him. I'll just use frigates on the next turn. It should go down to yellow on the next turn. It does have over 100 strength now, so it will take a while before I actually take it. But it is going to fall, eventually. He doesn't have enough defenses to prevent that from happening. And after that, I don't see what could threaten my victory in this game. Unless some kind of disaster happens, but I really don't see what would have to happen. Yeah, that's a lot of damage, 95. Oh wow, I actually lost this unit. That was a bit unfortunate. But that was only a Lancer. Not a big deal. I should be able to see the city if I move my frigate without having to keep my units in range. Let's see if I move here. No, I can't. That's annoying. So I have to keep something in Onondaga's range. Yeah, that's slightly annoying. Oh well, let's do it then. I can just keep moving in and out, but not like this. Oh great, I can't move this rifleman now. I guess I'll start doing that on the next turn. I can just move in, fire, and then move out, but I need this hex to be free. And my rifleman is currently occupying it. Oh well, I'll do it on the next turn. So much for this cannon. And he can't have much of an army left by now. I don't think so. What should I get in Athens? Everything. But I can't get everything at once. Maybe I should get walls just in case. I guess I can do that. I'm a bit paranoid. Maybe overly so. But it's better to be safe than sorry. Right. Actually, no, I can't move out of range. No, I can. Okay, good. This is looking quite good. Not sure if I will be able to actually take the capital in this part, but I'll try. I'm about to finish railroad. That will give me some extra production. But it will take a while to connect all my cities with railroad. Yeah, let's do it. What? You don't want to accept your own deal? That's annoying. Railroad is done. And I'm in modern era now. Nice. Let's have a look at diplomacy really quick and global politics. Here's Hiawatha. Yeah, he's only at war with me right now. Okay, he didn't build Statue of Liberty from what I see. So I think it's still up for grabs. And I definitely want it. Alright, let's continue. I'm going for replaceable parts next. To get Great War Infantry. I can actually use my frigate. I don't really need land units. But this is going to take a while. I only have two artilleries, I could use at least one more. But it will have to be enough. It will be enough, it's just going to take a while. And my Great Admiral is here. He's not going to be very useful now, but whatever, he's here. With my fleet. Not much I can do with this. I guess I'll just keep them here. Not much else I can do. Linz. What should I get in Linz? I think I'll just grab stock exchange. I need better income right now. So stock exchange here as well, but workshop first. Oh, what? Hold on, are Persians still at war with the Mongols? Let me check that. No, they aren't. They are just denouncing them. Why are they here then? Do they want to declare war on me? Well, Darius is friendly with me. Can I actually get declaration of friendship with him? No. Whatever, dude. I hope they don't want to declare war on me right now. I do have decent defenses over here, but I don't like the look of that. Sneaky bastards. Well, we'll see, I guess. Another stock exchange. Yeah, I think I'll have to finish this part before I take Hiawatha's capital, because it's been 50 minutes, I think. I'm not keeping track of time. But I don't like the look of this, not at all. I do have open borders with Darius, so I don't think he wants to backstab me. But I don't like these Mongol units over here. Alright, let's bombard the capital one more time. If it wasn't healing, this would be faster. Alright, so like I said, I'm actually going to finish this part here and continue the siege in next one. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.